Laura to Kirill.
And I'm to Mitch.
And this morning, we're going to continue talking about
friendship.
But before that, I have an exciting game.
Oh, so are you all excited?
Mm-hmm.
So our game for today is guess the title of the movie.
So we're going to show you some photos on the screen, and all you have to do is guess the name of the movie.
We'll give you 5 seconds to guess it. So let's start.
Now let's move on.
So the answer of that movie is
Coco.
So the next is my fourth one
is and time's up. So the fourth movie is okay, I hope you got it right, kids, because this next one is going to be our last one. Okay, are you ready? Now, 3, 2, 1, go! Now, the name of the last movie was?
Frozen!
That's right! So, how many points did you got, Ate Mitch?
I got 5 points!
How about you, kids? We love to hear how many points you got. So let us know in the comment section below. Okay?
So now,
if you're sitting down, get ready to stand up and sing and dance for the Lord. Okay? Bye!
Gonna love, love, love everybody the way you love me. This is your Atiella, and I am back to tell you more about friendship. Okay, speaking about friends, I have this friend of mine and she is having a very bad day. See, she woke up late that morning, that's the first thing, and because she woke up late, second, she skipped her favorite breakfast cereals because all of his siblings have eaten all of them. See how sad that is? But then, there's more. Since she woke up late, she was not able to see her favorite morning show. So, hey, that's a bad day already early in the morning. But, well, you know, kids, we all are having bad days and we can't help it because they happen. Now, for our story today, we are going to look at the life of this man named Job. Now, Job is a real person. And you can read all about Job in the Bible. Okay, now, Job didn't really have bad days all his life. In fact, Job was having a lot of very good days in his life. See, one thing that you will read about Job is like a very nice thing about Job. Like one of the best things you will know about Job is that Job loves God. Job loves God so much that even if the people around him doesn't trust God, Job still did. And Job is also a pretty successful man. So Job has a very big family, he lives in a big house, and he has all of these animals scattered all over his big land. Isn't it nice? So Job is actually living a very comfortable life. Very comfortable life. Until, unfortunately, his terrible, horrible, very bad day started. Okay, see here, one day while his donkeys and cattle were grazing around the field, a neighboring tribe came and attacked them. So the neighboring tribe took all over the animals and killed the servants that were watching them. Isn't that sad? But hey, there's more. A messenger came to Job saying that a lightning struck and killed all of the sheep and the servants that were watching the sheep. So that's donkeys all gone, cattle all gone, sheep's all gone. Hey, there's more. Another messenger came to Job saying that another neighboring tribe came and attacked the town of Job. And guess what they took? The neighboring tribe took all of his camels with them. They stole them away from the servants that were watching the camels. Wait, all donkeys gone, cattle all gone, sheep's all dead. And now the camels also gone? Well, not just that, but the servants are all gone too. Whoa, that's too much for Job. But hey, it didn't stop there. One day, when all of his family were on his house, a huge, big wind came and destroyed his house. And everyone, his house and his family, were gone. So Job was so sad. That's basically everything, everyone he loved, were all gone. That's so sad. But here's one more thing that has happened. And it's just very sad to think. Soon, after all that happened, Job is feeling all of these sores appearing in his body. Now, Job is also feeling physical pain. Job is now feeling physical pain and also the pain that he has in his heart just about the fact that he had lost everything. Okay, now, amidst of all of these, amidst of the pain that Job is feeling, he was not alone. Three friends soon came to visit Job when they heard about the terrible, horrible, bad day that happened to Job. And so they came to visit Job. So yes, they're his friends, but sometimes they don't know what to say, they don't know what to do. So even if these friends don't know how to help Job, they stayed with Job. You hear that? These three friends stayed with Job because they know that good friends care about each other. So, when Job was feeling all of this pain by himself, his friends stayed with him, not just with 1 or 2 days or 3 days or 4 days or 5 days, but his friends stayed with him for 7 days and 7 nights. All because they understand that good friends care about each other. Isn't it amazing? Okay, so kids, challenge for you this Sunday. We all are gonna have bad days. We are gonna have bad and sad days. And when we have those days, as a person, as a child, as a kid, we want to have friends that will care for us. So here's your challenge. Be a game changer and become a caring friend that will watch over their friends when they are having their bad days. Because here in UpStreet, good friends care about each other. Can you say that with me again? Good friends care about each other. Now, let's pray. Dear God, thank you for teaching us how to be good and caring friends. Thank you for giving us the story of Job and his life. And thank you for loving us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. So now, you will go to small group and you will be with Kuya Chan Chan for another small group time. So, bye for now!
Hello kids and welcome to UpStreet. And now we are here for our small group. Once again, it's me, Kuya Chan Chan. And for today, we are going to talk about our memory verse, which we have been talking about for the whole month. It is in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 11. Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up. So once again, therefore, encourage one another and build each other up. So this time, I'm going to show you some action which will help you memorize the verse better. Okay, here it goes. Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up. Okay, one more time. Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up. Now this time, we're gonna do it very slow so that everyone will catch up. Okay, let's start. Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up. Okay, so remember, it's in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 11. Okay, let's do it one more time so that everybody would memorize it and know the action. Okay, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 11. Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up. Okay, very good kids. I hope you've already memorized our verse and the actions. Thank you so much for participating today, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!